Students, today we are going to conduct a microscopic observation, and that is of stomatal cells. So we will actually observe the structure of stomata or stomatal cell under the microscope. And for this activity, we are using here some materials. Let me introduce you with the materials. First, we have taken betel leaves. All of you are familiar with this leaf. Then we have taken slides, cover slips, forceps, brush, spatula, watch glass. I have taken two watch glasses. One of them is used for keeping the water, plain water, normal water. And then what? I have taken safranin, which will help you to stain the stomatal cells. And obviously, we have taken our microscope. Now I will start with the process. This is the betel leaf, and this smooth portion of the leaf, this is the upper surface, and this is lower surface. Okay, so we have to tear it in such a way so that we can get the epidermal layer of the leaves, because the stomata cells are present on the epidermal part of the leaf. So you will hold the leaf in this way. The back side will be towards your face. Okay. So you will tear it in this way. Have you seen the process? Again, I am showing. You will tear it in this way. Now you see. Have you seen this layer? White in color. Have you seen? So this is the epidermal layer of the leaves. Okay, now we have to tear it, or we have to separate it with the help of forceps, and you have to keep it on the slide. So that thing should be done very carefully. You have seen, all of you have seen how I have torn the leaf, because that is very important part of this activity. Now I'll spray it a little bit of water, otherwise it will become dry. Then I will take just a drop of safranin, because if you add more dye, you know, it will become too dark and it will become very difficult for you to observe it under the microscope. So as less as you can, take less dye. Spread the safranin properly. Cover it with a cover slip. No bubbles should be present inside the cover slip. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you to see the cells. You have seen how I have put the cover slip. Now, we will place it under the microscope. And before that, let me tell you, we have taken here 15x and here 45x. Now we will observe the cell. Now we are observing the structure of stomata under the microscope. The stomatal pore or opening is enclosed by two bean-shaped cells. Those two cells are called guard cells. These guard cells control the closing and opening of stomatal pore, and stomatal pore helps the plant in gaseous exchange. All of you have seen the structure under the microscope. So what you have found? You have found this structure. There is a small opening which is known as stomatal pore or opening, and which is enclosed by two bean-shaped cells. Two bean-shaped cells, or we can say kidney-shaped cells. Okay, these two cells are known as guard cells. Now these guard cells are having a specific function. It controls the closing and opening of the stomata. And all of you know what is the function of stomata? It helps in gaseous exchange, because plants, they take carbon dioxide during photosynthesis and they take oxygen during respiration. So both this process needs gaseous exchange, and that is done by stomatal pore or stomatal opening. So this is all today we have come to know through our activity. Okay, so now one of you come and do. So I would like to call Adarsh to come do the process from the beginning.
Good morning, I am Adarsh and I am studying in grade 9 ICSC. So we have to first tear the betel leaf to observe the cells. So I have torn the epidermal layer of the leaf. Now I will add some water to it. So after adding the water, I am going to add the saffron in. I have added the saffron in to make it more visible under the microscope. So then I have to add the cover slip, and I have to place it in such a manner that there should be no bubbles inside it. And the slide is ready to be observed under the microscope. So I will place it under the microscope. So the cells have been observed under the microscope, and the observation is that stomata is a small opening or pore-like structure, and it is enclosed by two bean-shaped cells called guard cells.